joining us and you're here, we're going to talk about leads. Leads. We're going to talk about helping families, talking about building a business, going to talk about making money, and going to have some fun with this. Let's see. Oh, yes, I would, Ashlyn. Thank you. Okay. All right. We got some guests going to join me. And where to begin? All right. So if you're here, I'm thinking you might be brand new and saying, I heard there's leads. How does this work? If you're not brand new, you might be like, hey, what should I be thinking about to explode my business right now? And I'm going to hit you with a lot of ideas. We've got a lot going on. I've got some guests with me. I've got Ashlyn Davis from the Lead Performance Team. I'm going to have John Davis. He's going to be joining us from Bang Bang Social Media Leads. And I'm going to try to, oh, there's John. He's there. Okay, cool. And so I'm going to try to help you if you're here and you're watching this, whether you're watching this live or if you're seeing a recording of this later on, I'm going to try to give you tools that I know are working, that I know are helping other people perform at a high level right now. So you're here, you're in business, and you're trying to get your business better. I'm going to tell you, it takes three simple things for your business to work and for you to get it to where you want to be. If you're like, Mike, I'm trying to part-time make $1,000 a month, or I'm trying to make $1,000 a week, or Mike, I'm trying to make $5,000 a week, or Mike, I'm trying to make $8,000 a week. The formula is the same. It's going to take three things. It's going to take work. It's going to take leads, and it's going to take communication. And if I give you a formula, it's work times leads times communication equals results. So Ashlyn, can I put you on the spot, Ashlyn, if you want to open up your video and open up your microphone? I got a math quiz for you. We're going to see if Ashlyn can open up her mic, or do I have to unopen it for her? There we go. We got her, mic opened.
Can you hear me?
Ashlyn, do we get to see you smiling?
You should be able to. Let me text here real quick. It should have.
Oh, wait. Maybe. Well, it doesn't let me hide you. So. All right. Well, there we go. Hey.
Hi.
Hey, girl. How are we doing?
Good. How are you?
Hey, we're doing well. Okay. So here's my quiz. If somebody puts in work at like 100% and they got leads, so time work times leads at 100% and zero communication, what's 100 times 100 times zero?
They ain't gonna get nothing.
Zero, right. It's like, I just got done talking to some crazy fool, nice person, but she's like, I'm frustrated. I was like, well, how many dials did you make? Well, 240. I was like, well, who have you talked to in the last 4 days? Well, nobody. I said, well, you should be frustrated because you ain't following directions. I'm like, what am I supposed to say? If you can't communicate iteratively throughout the progress of work, you're going to get lost. So if you think you're going to come in and be a lone wolf, the lone wolves get eaten. So what is it that NC State says? They say the strength of the wolf is the pack. The strength of the pack is the wolf.
I believe that's right.
If you ain't part of the pack, you're going to get eaten. So just expect to die. Just go get yourself a burial policy because you're going to need one. Okay. Now, with that said, you could be working and communicating, but if you ain't getting leads, if you got zero leads, how good is all your effort of communicating and working going to be, Ashlyn?
If you're not working, if you're not communicating.
No, you have to say if you're working and communicating, but you got zero leads. So what's 100 work times 100 communication times zero leads?
Well, I hope you got some more market. I hope you got some friends and family to sell.
I'm saying, but they're getting zero
leads. They got nothing.
Nothing. 100 times 100 times zero is nothing. Forget about it. So you're going to have to get some leads. Now, you can get free ones, and we're going to show all the sources. So we're going to get into sources. So simple things. We're going to talk about five sources. Oh, we got someone who's coming. We may have a visitor. That could be opportunity knocking. Yes. He's got a debit card. You cannot do Mutual of Omaha. Oh, no, hold on. He has a debit card. It's tied to a bank. You need the bank account number, not the debit card number. So he's got to get the account number and routing number. Okay. He gave you the routing number, he gave you the debit card number. Well, he needs to give you the account number, not the debit card number. We're helping families, by the way. We're just live. Listen, we ain't pretending.
It locked everything after she signed the HIPAA.
Okay, why don't you refresh your screen or contact IGO and if you need to or something. But hey, close my door. Okay. That's all right. Hey, we got crazy people. People are selling deals. Like, all right, people come out. We're trying to write apps here, folks. So this is like live. We're in the middle of things. If you're wondering, who's these people talking to? There are agents that are on the phone talking to leads that are looking to buy life insurance. So I might get some more interruptions because we're social distancing and working from office at the same time. Okay, so leads. There's five categories that you can be exploring for leads, okay? First one we're going to talk about is we have a lead GMRs. Ashley's going to help me talk about that. I'm going to talk about that and what's going on there. Second, you can be getting what we call a lead bang bang social media leads. I got John Davis here going to talk about that. Third, we've got referrals that you should be picking up along the way. Fourth, we got your current clients if you've been with us. We're going to give you a peek at the CRM system, how you can tap into them. This is amazing stuff that Robbie Kraft and others have been working on. And then fifth, we've also got what we call the secret. It's still untapped. In fact, I almost debate not even telling everybody what I've learned about it. But since Ashley's here, she's probably going to make me tell y'all about accessing the discounted A leads from across the country. If you've got licensed people that we've not gotten to because nobody lived near them. But now that more people are doing telesales, there's no excuse for us not to be calling them. It's crazy, crazy, unbelievable. So with that said, we're going to kind of work our way through. This call's about leads. We're going to first talk about A-lead GMRs. Ashlyn, go ahead. What should people know about A-lead GMRs and some of the cool things that are going to happen for like final expense and mortgage protection, A-lead creation that's going on right now?
So A0 leads are the newest, freshest leads that we have. So if an agent gets an A0 lead, they're going to be the first person to receive that lead. Now, GMR stands for Geographic Marketing Request, and what that is it's a weekly subscription to leads coming in every single week. So what does that mean? If you set up an A0 GMR, we are going to automatically start pulling more data from the courthouses. We're going to start mailing and marketing more in that area that you want those leads in, so we can create that consistent lead flow coming in every single week for you, which also is going to require consistency with activity, consistency with making dials, consistency with selling over the phone more, or still getting in the homes, because we've got a lot of people who still want to see you. But that's also going to help more families and put consistent money back in your bank account every single week. But like Mike said, only if you put in the work, if you've got the leads and you have the communication. So some of the great benefits of having an A0 GMR is not only do we mail and market more specifically for you, but we can kind of get a better accurate idea of how many leads we can get you in a specific area every single week. So if you want to see 20 clients a week, we can get you 20 A leads a week. If you need 30 A leads a week, we can find an area to get you 30 A0 leads a week. If you're someone who only needs 5 A leads a week, that's okay too. We can find an area and get you 5 A0s in as well. So some of the great benefits of the GMR also is that you get first priority and access to all of the brand new A leads every single day before they hit the instant purchase map. So we're going and giving you those A0 leads to you guys who have GMRs. And then each morning, whatever is left over that we can't give out to the GMRs is then what gets put on the instant purchase map. So you kind of get, you know, second dibs on those A leads if you're not getting them through an A0 GMR. Another thing is predestined leads. We've always had predestined call-in telemarketing and speed leads, but we just recently added on direct mail predestined leads. So what a predestined lead is as soon as that lead is created, if you've got a GMR in that area and it's not filled for the week, we're going to automatically send you an email so you can be on the phone booking an appointment within 5 to 10 minutes of that client calling in and providing us all of their information asking for help. So you do get predestined A0 leads, and you can only get those on an A0 GMR.
Okay. So GMR A0 leads. These are like fresh, hot off the griddle, or if you're like a big Krispy Kreme donut guy, like I've eaten a couple in my life, the best time to get that Krispy Kreme donut is when that red light in the circle is on, because you know
that red light for leads.
The enrobing machine, that's like, so getting a GMR is like getting the donuts when the red light is on at Krispy Kreme. And so it's kind of like, as we get to talking to John and with Bang Bang Social Media, you want to get them as they're coming in. You don't want to wait till my dial day. And in fact, one of the crazy things with people doing more telesales, whether you're doing telesales or in person, is getting the idea of get them as they come in, call them, whether you sell them that day, go see them that day or the next day is so critical, especially now. There's a huge sense of urgency. The media is marketing for us 24/7. We really need that.
People are freaking out wanting help.
Yes. Now, as we talk about different lead types, I was thinking about one of my favorite movies that's got a clip that just relates to leads and different lead types. Now, Ashland, are you at all a Monty Python fan? It's
no
okay if you're not. My buddy John Davis would probably appreciate this more. John Davis, are you an all Monty Python fan?
Oh, man, how did I know you were going to say that? That's cracking me up.
Okay, so we're going into the crypt. We're going to the Life of Brian, for those that know this movie. And, so we're going to pull this up because this little clip just – I think it says a lot. I'm going to kind of get this rolling here, see if I can pull this up in a way. Let's see, full screen. Let's see if I can do this here. Share my screen. I don't know if I can do full screen, but I'm going to pull this up in a way. Let's see. Give me a second because I like this. And this helped when I'm thinking about the different types of leads and how to invest in leads. This says a lot to me, this little short piece here. So here we go. So we got these two guys, they're walking down a dirt road and they're going to the stoning. Ashlyn, do you know what a stoning is?
Nope, I don't think so.
That's when somebody said something blasphemous and they're going to be stoned to death, okay? So they're walking down the road, they're headed to the stoning and they're stopping by their stone vendor along the way. So here we go.
Stones, sir. Nah, they got them up there, lying around on the ground.
Oh, not like these, sir. Look at these. Feel the quality of that. Craftsmanship, sir.
Well, I've had 2 weeks, boys. And a flat one.
No, I'm a flat one, Mum. Sorry, Dad.
Yeah, all right. 2 points, 2 flats, and a packet of gravel.
Packet of gravel.
A packet of gravel.
Good one this afternoon.
Yeah.
Local boy.
Oh, good.
Enjoy yourselves.
Gonna stone the local boy. All right. All right, so people are like, what's that got to do with leads? Well, look, if you're going to go to a stoning, you need to bring some stones. So there they got the round ones, the flat ones, the pointy ones, and a bag of gravel. That's what you need to be thinking about when you're getting ready for your attack and selling, is you need a bunch of different types of leads. So that's kind of why we're talking about the five different types here. So, and, you know, we talk about, hey, these are well-crafted leads, just like these well-crafted stones as you're going to the stoning. All right, so... pardon the humorous introduction or interjection there, but the next type of leads, as we talk about A leads, is what we call our Facebook final expense leads. And that's what we got John Davis, who runs Bang Bang Social Media. And John has been working with several of our agents for almost, what, about 6-7 weeks now, John?
Yeah, since March for sure, early March. Okay. Been a good time.
All right. And so we've got a number of agents. In fact, the two agents have just walked in. I think one or both of them are probably working on a Facebook sale, if I'm not mistaken. And so we've got people that are using the Facebook leads, talking to them, and they're working. They're coming in hot. John, I've got some of the screens I can share. I can pull up that you sent me. So I'll kind of let you lead, and I'll kind of just provide some of the visual here for people that are looking at this and wondering, got questions.
Sounds good, too. And I was actually able to get stopped, so I can share my screen and do that as well, if that works.
Fantastic. I think we can let you do that. So if you've got the green screen share button, yep. Let's see if it's working. Go right ahead.
And I turned my 10-year-old twins on to Monty Python. Not all of it, but briefly, they seen the stoning the other night. Man, it was funny all over again. So thanks for a reminder. That's a very good scene. If nobody's ever watched it, go ahead and finish that clip. So, I will share my screen here. Let me know, Mike, if you can see it. first thing I'll pull up is the order website. Can you see that, Mike?
It's not coming up yet. And I don't know if Tia has to allow you to share or not. Let me see.
That's okay. Then we don't have to go through that.
I can pull it up because I've got most of the stuff. If you don't. Oh, it's coming up now, John. Go ahead.
Okay. Yeah, it would have helped if I clicked the share button. Okay, okay. Awesome. Then I can see you still too. Hey, what's up, Ashlyn? I see you over there as well. Thank you so much for all your help. So, and hopefully there's not too much distraction in my background. So, hey, thanks everybody. My name is John Davis with Bang Bang Leads. I live in St. Louis, Missouri. I've known Mike Levantovich, my gosh, for 7 years probably, something like that, long time. Awesome. And a bunch of other folks at the Alliance. This has been a great relationship coming back around. So this is the main order page. Mike was just talking about a couple of his agents making calls using our leads. I have one type of lead. It's generated on Facebook. It's specifically a final expense lead. We're targeting people ages 50 and up, along with other criteria that we asked Facebook to look for. And I could show you some pictures or you know, even answer some questions. Mike's probably got some about what people see or the experience. This is the order page. It's real simple. If you don't have it, it's bangbangleads.com. We're continuing to make changes in the background, but for now, this is working really well. And there's two types of leads that you can order. And when I say that, it's basically just the difference between the two is the radius or where you're going to get them and the cost. The experience and the lead itself, the quality of the lead, what you're getting is the exact same whether you do a telesale statewide or you do a targeted lead, which would be more intentional for setting an appointment and going and seeing people face to face. Make sense so far, Mike?
Yes, sir.
All right. So I just wanted to show folks on ordering. If you click the telesale statewide, the main thing this is going to do is affect the pricing right here. So you're going to see it starts at 20 leads. They're $15 each. So if you're looking, if you're on an order page and it says $15 each, you're going to be getting a statewide lead. We see somebody awesome here has bought some leads recently on your guys' team. That's great. I guess it's safe. Yeah. So everybody knows these people. I guess I better watch that. Because we're not too far.
I already got our credit card number. We placed another order. Thank you, Diane.
Hey, Merry Christmas, Diane. Take another Ferrari. Okay, so I just wanted to show folks that, and it's a simple experience. You put in your contact info, how many leads you want. It'll calculate the cost, and when you click submit, we get your order and we start working on them. The other type of lead that you have is targeted. Again, it's going to be a very similar looking website. It's just changing the price here, and make sure I don't have anybody else's information. So when you order statewide, in the lead location, you're going to put just the state abbreviation, or you could put this. If you're licensed in multiple states, put them all in there. It's not going to hurt anything. If you're looking for local leads, then in this area, you just want to put your zip code or a city and state. We drop a pin and a map, kind of like if I said Troy, Missouri, I'm going to go to Google and find the center point of Troy, Missouri, and then we go out from there. So your leads will be around 50 miles from that center point. Make sense?
Yep.
Cool. When you do order, you should immediately get a confirmation email that says, thank you for the order. It'll have a couple short videos about our lead portal and what to expect. It'll tell you, you can access the lead portal once you receive your first lead. So when you order, if you do not get a email, then your order didn't go through, or, and it could just be your credit card vendor, your bank, the first time you order with something new online, it may just decline it, or you entered your email wrong. So, and both of those have happened. I've had people call me a day or two later. I haven't got any leads, and only to find out that their order didn't go through or their email was wrong. So if you don't get a lead within 24 hours or so, don't wait a week to contact me or your manager. There's an error. It's either, it's most likely a human error if it's been more than 48 hours.
Okay.
Good so far?
Yeah, and I think I've seen some people, their leads are coming through, but they're going to their junk mail, and they've not seen them or looked for them in their junk mail or their portal, which I see you're pulling up right now.
100%, and I've gotten, I got my phone on mute, but the only people that it can ring through are my children, and somebody just called. So, yes, so check your junk folder, and reach out to me. You can contact me easily, text, phone, email, whatever works. So, Mike, I have your account pulled up. Is that okay with you?
That's fine.
People see your leads. All right. So I just asked first. So if you've never been in the lead portal, you don't have to go in here. You get your leads emailed to you one by one, but you get access to this. It's really easy to find. You simply go to, what is it? I got too many. I'm bang. bangbangleadportal.com. So we can share that, bangbangleadportal.com. And it's going to take you, it's bangbang.leadportal.com. And it's going to take you to a sign-up page, and you enter your username and password, and you'll get that in the welcome email. This is what you see most of the time when you log in. So if you log in for the first time and you're looking for your leads over the toolbar, I'm just going to hit like two or three of the most common questions I get. I logged into the portal. I can't find my leads. Go over to the toolbar on the left and click on my leads. That usually takes care of it. I logged onto the portal and I click my leads and I can't see them. There's a little calendar here. It's a select a date range calendar. That probably means you didn't get any leads today. So whatever date it's set on, it just means no leads came into your portal during that time. So an easy thing to do is just click like all, and it's going to pull up all your leads. Another question that I get is, can I export these things like in a bulk, like a batch print to like a PDF or something like that? And that answer is yes as well. This little deal here, once you have your leads, it's a funnel. It's a filter. It looks like a golf tee. Click it. You can search all kinds of things. If Mr. Jones calls and doesn't leave your number, or you don't know who he is, you can type in a last name. It'll pull up anybody with that last name. If you're getting leads in multiple states, you can search multiple states. Bunch of filters in here, mess with them. The easiest thing though to do to batch print is just click select all, and then back here, down here in this little filter button, click it. It's gonna, then all you have to do is simply put your email here and check how, whatever you want. Do you want to export Excel or PDF? And there's other things too. Most people are looking for batch print PDF. So if you, Mike, if you put your email in here, click PDF, hit send here, you're going to get one email with a PDF with like however many leads you have. It says there's 95. Mm-hmm. You're going to get an email with not, and hit print, 95 leads will print off. Does that make sense?
Yes, sir.
Okay, cool. What other questions do you have?
Let's see. I think this is a good start. And I think I'm going to clarify, just kind of talk about. So if somebody said, hey, I'm looking for leads, should I do statewide or local? Well, if you're realizing that a lot of people are like tired of being quarantined and they're very lonely and they want to see you face to face, I'd say there's high value in getting your leads localized. Now, if you're like, I am personally susceptible health-wise, and I'm going to die if I get this COVID and I need to not be seeing people, then you should get the statewide or multiple states. The telemarketed list is what you need to be focused on, is what I would tell people. But we have agents that are still meeting with people or are starting to again gradually as the situation dictates, right? But for the people that are like, recognize that folks want to be met with and they're doing that, you've got that opportunity. So I just want people to know that we're seeing, you know, where for a while, yes, we were trending down in terms of more telesales. We're seeing, okay, there the people like, yeah, I'm tired of being cooped up. Please come over. You know, I'm going to kill. I don't know. Can I blame it on the COVID if my husband's body turns up, you know?
Right.
So he said, can I blame it on the COVID if they find my husband's body in the backyard? I might kill him because he's been here too long.
That'd be so, like a new Milli Vanilli song.
All right. So I just want people to know both are good and this can be a tool. So like if somebody's starting to build a lead portfolio, here's my suggestion. Number one, make sure you got yourself a GMR for some direct mail leads coming in based on 3, 5, 10, whatever it is you're trying to do. Number two, if you need a batch to boost things, get yourself an order of Facebook leads from John. That'd be the second big thing I'd be thinking about. And then the next big thing I'd be thinking about as we talk about different types is, hey, are you getting referrals? Are you using the ERS referral system? I'm not going to train on that now, but just please, please, please access that, leverage it, and use it. And that's going to be another piece of what's going on. The fourth thing, if you haven't seen, is our CRM system, which is bad to the bone. In fact, John, have you seen this? Are you aware of the updates that they've put together here for us as agents?
No, I haven't. I'm excited to see it. We're working on getting the leads directly, like my leads, Bang Bang leads, directly ported into you guys. And that, every time I hear somebody talking about Dark Andy or on one of the calls, it sounds amazing. I know what it takes for us to do similar stuff. So to have access to that and just be part of your of what's included being an agent with the Alliance is massive. I mean, that costs massive amounts of money and manpower to keep something like that going.
So I'm going to do a screen share here. I'm logged in Noelle's account, but I'm just going to give a quick glimpse so people can see what's there for them as they start to build their business. So I'm going to do a quick screen share. And there's been training done on this, so this is just meant to give you a taste. But if nothing else, the first thing is your clients are in this CRM system. And John, we've got this Today tab that's got a list of upcoming policy reviews, conversion opportunities, Medicare Advantage, Medicare Supplement opportunities, chargebacks, or birthdays. So let's say policy reviews. Now, there's none in here, but if there were, it would say, hey, you have annual reviews coming up in the next week for people. There's 6-month, 9-month, 12-month reviews. Conversions, if you've got clients that have a policy, like I could look at this Raymond Jeffries, hey, he got a policy. I can click on it. It's going to tell me his information over here. And I can reach out to him and say, hey, Bo, you're due to have your policy reviewed. And by the way, you may qualify to lock in a permanent policy. You can do the same thing with other people here listed in this conversion list of opportunities for us to go and talk to them about upgrading their policy to a permanent policy because their term is going to run out. And we've got the same things posted with Mutual of Omaha and with CFG and Nassau Re with their convertible products. And once they've been in on the books for 2 years, it's going to flag you to say, hey, here's what's going on. Here's who you should be talking about. For Medicare Advantage, John, for people that are turning 65 today, in a month, or in 2 months, we've got this flag so we can reach out to them and call them and give them a shout. Like Noah Gerald is turning 65 here in about 2 months. I can click on his name. It's going to bring up his contact info. I can give him a call, text, or email or mail and say, Bo, time is ticking. We got to get to you. Hurry up. So if you're AHIP certified, you got your health license, this is going to be up your alley. If you don't have your AHIP, what are you waiting for? Come on, stop watching Netflix and Hulu and do a little studying. Do something to make some money. Don't just sit there and spend money and time. Go get your AHIP certification. It's easy. You can do it fast. Okay. From there, if you'd had a chargeback and you want to call and help get the policy back on the books, it's there. And you've got birthdays. You can reach out to your clients. The numbers are here. If you missed their birthday or if you got today's birthdays or upcoming birthdays, it tells you when they are. You don't even have to search. The reports are coming up. So you can wake up at 6 in the morning and have a short list of here's my to-do list for today. So even if you've only been with us 3 months, your clients are in here. And you can start making sure. So it's another tool for you as you're building your working list of what do I got to do today? Okay, so that's my next big thing. And we're going to get to another lead type. But before that, I want to hit on some concept stuff because people say, well, Mike, what's a smart lead investment? How do I know how much I should be putting in? Here are some guidelines to help you. If people are asking me brand new, say, Mike, what should I be putting in? Here's a general rule of thumb, a 5X multiplier. You want to make $1,000? One-fifth of it needs to be in leads. So you say, I want to make $1,000. What about $200 into leads? I want to make $2,000. What's 20% of that? About $400, okay? Now, here's the cool thing. As you're in business with us for a year, you've got back-end money, renewals, current clients, bigger sales, conversions, all that stuff's happening. You should be doing a higher volume on the same lead budget, or maybe you're doing lower lead budget, but the same volume. I like the higher volume personally, more sales, more revenue, but keeping the lead budget the same. So now if maybe you put in 400 a week in year one and you made 2000 a week and you were gross to 100,000, hey, this next year, if you keep that lead budget the same, you're at higher commission levels, you got renewals, back end money, bigger sales, you should be pulling in 120, 130, 140, 150,000, like 3000 a week, or more for the same $400 a week lead investment. That should be happening if you're playing the game and using all these tools properly. So that's a big, big deal. Okay, that's one thing. So that's what I call the 5X plan. Now, you'll be more efficient later on. Now, hey, guess what? You might really suck at first and maybe you've gotta be a little bit less efficient. In fact, I'm gonna give you two business models. Ashton, I got another math quiz for you. Okay, get ready. All right, sorry to put you on the spot. So here's business model A. Business model A, the agent has $1,000 in revenue for the week and $200 invested for leads. So he nets $800, but he invested $200, grossed $1,000, nets $800. Business model B, he grossed $2,000. He invested $800 in leads. He put in four times as much money. He invested $800 in leads, He grossed $2,000. He netted $1,200. Which business model do you want, Ashland? Which one are you voting for? The first one
or the second one? If I remember.
Why the second one?
Because he invested more. He probably got more leads, probably helped more families, and he put more money back in his bank account to reinvest back in leads.
Okay. Now, I got some people say, well, I want the more efficient business where he only put in $200, made $1,000 to net his $800. So if it's you and it's your business, you told me why. John, which one are you voting for?
I want the one with more money.
More money. That's right. So some people think, I want the more efficient one. You look lazy, fool. What you need to do is figure out how do I get more families help and get more money. Net money is what we're looking for. So it's nothing wrong with investing $800 to gross $2,000 to net $1,200, because last I checked, a net of $1,200 is more than a net of $800, unless they're teaching some new math I don't understand. Okay?
I'm going with PD.
You're doing your homeschool and your own kids. Maybe you might be confused, or your kids might be. All right. So here's what I'm saying is, like, guys, when you're first starting getting out and getting it going, it's not about who can have the most efficient business. It's about who can get the biggest business, get their revenue higher, get their contract level higher, get a bigger book of business so they've got more people in their CRM to be talking to in their second year, more people to get referrals from, more people to convert. It's how fast can I get big? And if you understand that, don't worry about the efficiency. Focus about getting results, getting big, and let efficiency come later. So that's a huge, huge mindset. Some people are afraid to open up and reinvest. I'm like, don't be scared. Scared money, don't make no money, or make some, but not a lot. You want to make more and get your business rolling, and don't be worried. Give yourself enough shots to get out there. And you say, Mike, what if I'm tight on my budget? If your budget's tight, start where you got to start. Figure out, what can I sell? You can sell blood plasma. They're still buying it. They need it more than ever with this COVID stuff. So you sell blood plasma. You can sell your neighbor's toaster. Okay? Don't sell your own. You might need toast. But just don't let them catch you taking it. Okay? But from there, find something. You got to sell something to get some leads, get something going. Hey, get a couple warm market policies sold. But when you get that money coming in, don't be like, I got to put it on the bills. Ain't nobody paying their bills in this economy right now. Ain't nobody going to miss your money. Go get more leads so you can go helping more people. That would be my thinking. Your landlord is not going to evict. Ain't nobody getting evicted right now. Last I checked. Okay. So, but main thing is can you get to a mindset where you're reinvesting your business first so you've got more money to deal with your bills? The bills are going to be there next month. Some of y'all thinking, is this guy crazy? I am, but I'm telling the truth. So that's, if I can help people see that and learn to prioritize, invest in getting your business moving, and then worry about efficiency. So that's huge. We've got some folks that are crushing it, and they're crushing it because they're investing $500, $600, $800, $1,000 a week into their leads, but that's why they're grossing $3,000, $4,000, $5,000, and $6,000 in revenue on the backside. Okay. Because they're not scared to have ramped up and taken some steps and moving. Now, should you drop $1,500 your first week in leads? If you ain't sold a policy yet, that's up to you. I don't know that I would do that, but if you can drop in $300, $400, $500, or $600, and then as soon as you see return, don't hesitate to chop it back down and double down as needed and get yourself working. And it's the work times the leads times the communication is going to get you the results. And that's why don't just keep buying leads and doing work and not communicating, because there's stuff to learn. You got to talk to people like Ashlyn. You got to talk to people like John. Say, John, don't answer my call. Well, text him 7 times. He'll return your call. John, hey, do people have permission to blow up your phone?
Man, you better blow it up. Like, I've looked down right now since I cleared out my text, there's 53 unanswered ones.
Okay. So
blow it up.
Guess what? He's going to answer the one that texted the most. Like,
the
well,
one's on top.
He should just love me and return my text anyways. Folks, he's going to return the one he sees the most.
I texted him 3 days ago.
I sent him half a text once. I said, like, come on now. Folks,
I texted you once.
That's okay. John's working 7 days a week. I know, because I've called him at 11 o'clock on a Sunday night or 7 o'clock on a Saturday morning. Folks, we are working. We have been praying for a tsunami wave to push our business like we're seeing right now. we've not seen it this good. I hope you're getting yourself a paddle and another paddle and a motor to put on your boat, an electric troll motor, hiring some kids to help you paddle. Get going. We're catching this wave. So if you see this, I seriously hope you do. We've got one more lead type we want to get into, these multi-leads. Ashlyn, do you mind pulling up the lead map of the U.S.? I'm going to share one of my personal secrets. So for the people that have hung on so far, I'm thinking they might like this. Okay.
Right. Can you guys see my screen?
It's coming up. I see it now. Okay, so Ashlyn, here's what I want you to show. If you can go to inventory and you can pull up mine. That's fine. Okay. You go to inventory. Yeah, whatever screen you want to show, that's fine. Okay, so now if somebody goes to inventory and I want you to click A series and DLP, A. Here we go. And then type hit all. All. Okay. Then hit apply filters. Okay. Now I want you to go to price. Hit click on the word price up at the top of the column. There we go. Now click it again so it goes the other direction. All right. So here's my magical tip. If you're looking at leads, look at that. You can get final expense speed lead for 29 cents. There's two of them in Brazos County, Texas. There's another discounted A lead for 29 cents in Lincoln, Louisiana. Okay, you get the idea. Look at all them 29 cent leads that you can get. John's like, I can't compete with that. Okay, if you're doing telesales, now watch this. We could click on a state. Let's pick a state that you probably – what's a state, Ashley? You know there's a bunch of, like, discounted leads that probably ain't nobody got to in certain corners. Like, let's pick Montana or California. Okay, you click
California. I know California has a ton.
Okay, look at these. These are – in fact, now let's even make it a little bit better. I want you to go to type, Ashley, and let's just show the DLPs that haven't been sold. So just click on – yeah, they're not sold. And the DLP, you got it. There you go. You're fast. Damn, you're good, girl. You've been doing this before. You're thinking like me. Okay, look at this. Now, these aren't just discounted A leads. These are discounted A leads that have never seen the light of day. Nobody's ever attempted to call these people. They're 82 cents a piece, $1.65 a piece. I mean, and you can see where they're all over. But it don't matter if you've got a California non-resident license, you can call all of them. I mean, folks, let's just say you got some of these, and let's say the average cost, if you got 100 of them, if the average cost is $2 a piece, okay, so you spent $200 for 100 responses that have never been called. If you can't turn that into $400, I'm going to smack the taste out of your mouth. We're going to come over there. We're going to say, Bo, give them to me. I'll find some Riri that can help these people out. Come on, man. I was like, we need your help. So if you can go, this is the bag of gravel I'm talking about when we come back to My Life of Brian. If you're going to the Stony, get your bag of gravel. Get you some round ones with your GMR. Get you some pointy ones with your Facebook leads. Get you some referrals, get into your CRM, and get yourself enough, and then strap in, buckle into your seat, sit there for 4 hours, and work the little telehopper. That's all you got to do. What do you want? I want to be a blessing in this crazy economic time. I want to be the people helping turn the economy around. I want to be one paddling the life raft, not the one that they got to pull out of the water and drag on it. Don't you? You can be offering people help. We come back to, what do I want? Simple, clear goals. You know, what's the most valuable task? How do I get it? I get it by getting leads, working, and communicating. And if we will do that, you can be as good as a Megan Wood, or as a Katrina Gustin, or as a Joseph Dukes, or a Junior Correa, or a Marcus Richardson. I mean, there's people out there. I start naming names. We got people crushing it and killing it right now. Just because they're doing those three things. They're getting leads, they're working, they're communicating. All right, Ashlyn, what have I forgotten to tell the folks?
I think you covered a lot of it. You covered all the DLPs. But you're right about a lot of people right now are going. I talked to Danny Johnson this morning. He went in and got 54 older DLPs for like $123. a lot of people are going on right now and buying a ton of old leads because A, they're so cheap, because Andy dropped all the price for multi-leads down to a 55% contract pricing. So the lowest price that you can pay for multi-leads. So everybody right now is going crazy on the phone, going and buying so many multi-leads. And like you said, any state that they're have a non-residence in or have a license in, they're going and buying as many multi-leads and DLPs as they can and hammering on the phone.
Yep. And so, like, here's what I know. Somebody's going to watch this video. Like, I knows how many people are on here. We got 30-some people, but there are going to be people watch this. They're going to catch on to this trick about these not solds. But guess what? We still got all the RWs, A3s, A2s, RW2s, the DLPs that have been sold. I mean, my gosh, y'all can go out there and get 100 leads for somewhere between $150 and $200, no matter who you are, and just be sitting there cranking it out. And if you can't find a sale out of 200 of them suckers, I say, you need to have your head examined. You ain't communicating or you ain't trying. So come on, you should be able to win at this game. Seriously, no joke. And then what you do is when you get a sale off of one of them $2 leads, you take the $200, $300, or $400, go get yourself a loaf of peanut butter, a loaf of bread and some peanut butter, and then put the rest toward leads. So next week you can eat steak. Okay. But don't try to eat steak on the first sale. Go get more leads and get you the loaf of bread and the peanut butter. All right, John, what else am I missing?
Man, I don't know if anybody else, I don't think everybody else can see the people that are you, me, an astronaut on the bottom. I feel like it reminds me like I'm on the Jerry Lewis telethon. Astronaut with her headset on, talking about get the deals, showing it people, her phones are ringing in the background, fired up. I don't know if anybody remembers that. But or like right. the telethon on the public channel. Yeah, all good.
Oh shoot, I need a thermometer of like the deals that are being closed in the background as we're sitting
every
here
time
talking.
It goes to Ashland, it's got all the stuff in the back. You need a bunch of people on the phones back there. It'd be awesome.
Oh, crazy. All right. Well, Ashland, I'm hoping this has been helpful for the people that are watching. And I don't know if T has got questions that have come through that we should answer. But if everything's good, like I said, I'm just gonna recap. If you miss out at the beginning, it takes leads, work, and communication. That's it. Okay. We've been talking about the leads, five sources to look at leads, GMRA leads, bang, bang, social media leads, getting your referrals, your CRM that you can access through the ARC, which has been unbelievably enhanced in the last week. And then the multi-A leads, the DLPA leads, the fact that you can get 100 of them or 200 of them for like $150, $300, whatever it is. So that's massive, massive, massive stuff. You understand how to access all five of these, whether for you or the agent you're getting started, put in the time, calling, put in the work, put in the communication, and you will get the results. I promise that. Make it happen. All righty, let's see.
One thing I would want to hit on too is that, because yes. I don't know if a lot of people know about this. Let me share my screen back with you guys. Can y'all see my screen?
I sure can.
Okay. So if you're looking at setting up an A0 GMR, something that will also help out is we do have a final expense heat map. So you can use this final expense heat map, and it's kind of color-coded, as you can see. And obviously, the green areas are going to be where we can create more leads. Red areas are going to be, you know, a little slim. But if you go to this final expense heat map, it's going to show you the map of the U.S. And if you scroll down, you can go in any state that you want to look at. So like if we click on California, this is going to show you and break it down county by county where we can produce final expense A leads. So over here, it's going to have the color-coded map. If you see the dark green areas, that means we can probably create anywhere from 51 plus leads a week for you. So this map is a really, really, really good tool to also see where we have some new leads and where we have places that we need help. So definitely this final expense team map helps out a lot with seeing a lot of those areas. And we have some people who are also using this as tools to recruit. So they're looking and seeing where we have leads, where we can create a lot of leads, where we have hotspots, and where we have leaders. And they're focusing on those areas in recruiting because we've got the leads, we've got the leaders, we've got the hotspots, we've got everything, you know, we need to help that new agent get started. So okay. Final expense heat maps. Go ahead.
And I'm looking. So where did you go to get to that final expense heat map?
That is going to be, if you go up to the lead tool tab.
Oh, I see it.
Tab,
yeah, yep. I found it on mine.
Final
okay.
Final expense heat map. Mm-hmm.
That's pretty cool. That's crazy good. So basically, the red places are where, like, nobody lives or a bunch of young people live, or the gray areas are, like, which is basically about nobody lives. Don't mean you can't get any leads. Just don't expect much.
Yes.
But, okay.
And call us, too, because we have a lot of new resources on the lead side of things that we have access to that you guys can't see. So, you know, if you call and say, hey, I want to go and look in this county and set up a GMR, I want to get 10 final expense leads here a week, I can pull up that specific county and get an idea of, hey, I can create 50 final expense leads here a week if you wanted it. So we have those resources to say, hey, no, that county is not going to produce what you're looking for on a weekly basis. But this county, which is maybe a neighboring county, will produce exactly what you're looking for on a weekly basis.
Okay. I think that's big because you could be watching this video now and we're recording this. And again, if you're thinking telesales, great. But if you're realizing, hey, people want to be visited again, people want to be taken care of, you know, this COVID, it's not going away. It's going to be around. We're not going to have a vaccine for a while. I'm not trying to speak negative. It's going to take a while for this to get sorted out. People are going to be concerned about getting it for a while, which means they're going to be thinking about dying or whatever else. So we need to make sure people get covered before the COVID gets them. And so the final expense area is a big part of that. And this map will help you figure out as people are more cool with us meeting them face to face. It's going to help us out a bunch. You should be doing stuff locally in your community to help get with these people or the nearby communities. So that's big. All right, Ashlyn, I'm glad I learned something because I hadn't seen this yet. I'd heard it was out there. I forgot to look. Thank you for bringing it up.
Absolutely.
Okay. Anything else we got to hit, Ashlyn?
I think you hit everything. Also, just so you guys know too, yes, we are doing telesales, but I promise you there are thousands of people who are begging people to come to their house and see them. So do not sit at home just because that's what everybody else around you is doing. Still get out and sit down and meet face to face with as many clients as you can, because that's where those big relationships happen. When you're in the home, you know, bonding with that family, meeting their kids, you know, cooking dinner for you, you know, and showing you their family's pictures. That's where those big relationships are built. So we still have people who are begging literally someone to come to their house. So please also still go out and visit those people. I mean, they're bored right now. They're lonely. They would love for somebody to come over and talk to them and help them.
Got that right. That's massive. All right, folks, we need people that want to get out there and see them. Work, leads, communicate. Those are the big things. Get out there, see it, folks. Got to get them helped. Hey, Ashlyn, John, thank you so much. Hopefully this is helpful. Y'all take care.
Thank you.
All righty.